experience CBS News.
Madeline Stowe, Bruce Greenwood, Saving Millie, CBS 10.
March Madness once again. From the first round tip all the way to the trophy presentation, CBS is your home for all the excitement and emotion that can only be found in the NCAA basketball tournament. I'm joined by my partners Clark Kellogg and Sports Illustrated Seth Davis, and the only obstacle I can see is my use of the English language.
Well, let's get rid of that and move right through it and get ready to unveil these brackets. That's right.
Just read.
All right, guys. Coming up, we will bring you the exclusive live announcement of the seedings and pairings for the tournament. Get your pencils and your brackets ready. Our experts will review the field once it's set and give us their picks. And after that, we'll have plenty of questions for Bob Bowlsby, chair of the NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Committee. First, a little background. There are 65 available tournament bids. 31 are automatically given to conference champions. 34 are at-large bids. An opening round game will be played in Dayton Tuesday night to narrow the field to 64. Once again, the committee has made an effort to keep as many teams as possible close to home for their first and second round games. As was the case last year, the committee has ranked the four number one teams to set up a potential Final Four where, if the teams win out, the overall number one seed would play the fourth number one seed in one national semifinal, and the second and third number one seeds potentially matching up in the other. With that in mind, we begin with a look at this year's number one seeds. The top overall seed is Illinois, which will play in the Chicago Regional. Fighting Illini off their Big Ten championship and the top number one seed overall. The second number one seed is North Carolina, which will play in the Syracuse Regional. And as Illinois has all season long, the Tar Heels have made a strong case for being a top seed in the NCAA tournament. The third number one seed is Duke, which will play in the Austin Regional. The Blue Devils, coming off the ACC Tournament Championship, their sixth in 7 years. And there were some questions, but not in the minds of the Blue Devils. The fourth number one seed is Washington, which will play in the Albuquerque Regional. And the Washington Huskies, an outside shot in the minds of many, they are celebrating like wildfire at the University of Washington over a hard-fought and, in the minds of some, a very well-deserved number one seeding. The Washington Huskies are a number one seed in the upcoming NCAA tournament. Now, here's how the brackets shape up. Based upon where the four number one seeds have been assigned, the winner of the Chicago Regional will meet the winner of the Albuquerque Regional in one national semifinal game. The other semi will pit the winner of the Syracuse Regional and the winner of the Austin Regional. You will see those games from St. Louis on Final Four Saturday, April the 2nd. It begins at 6 Eastern time here on CBS. And then on Monday night, April the 4th, CBS Sports will present the national championship game at 9 Eastern time. Seth and Clark, we've been talking all day long about the possibility of three number one seeds coming out of the ACC. It didn't happen for Wake Forest. It did for Lorenzo Romar and the Huskies.
Well, we've been crunching these numbers all weekend, and the more we crunched a little bit more today, you thought that Washington had an outside chance, really a good case when you took a look at all of their numbers. You also thought, you take a look at some of the other ones, you see Illinois, North Carolina, Duke, Washington, the number one seeds. But we also had discussed over the last 2 weeks some other teams, Kentucky, Kansas, prominently Wake Forest, even up until today, Oklahoma State.
Right. Well, congratulations to Washington. They played their way into this, no question. But obviously, Kentucky and Kansas losing this week opened up those spots. And very curious that Wake Forest gets left on the two. Duke is the one. Wake finished two games ahead of them in the ACC regular season. So once again, the conference tournament is what matters.
And perhaps the toughness of the ACC may have carried Duke to that number one.
How about Illinois? How about Illinois' situation as the number one overall in the tournament?
I don't think there's any debate there. I mean, they've been the best team all year long. They've been the most consistent of the top teams all year long, and I think they deserve exactly what they've gotten there.
Interesting that Oklahoma State didn't get to the one line, even though they won the Big 12. I'd wonder if that result happened too late for the committee to integrate into their decision.
All right, guys, let's bring in Jim Nance and Billy Packer, who join us shortly. We remind you, you can get live video from all the tournament games not shown in your area, plus live tournament press conferences, highlights, and more. Sign up for NCAA March Madness on demand only at NCAAsports.com or at CSTV.com. The NCAA tournament's truly a national event. Here's a look at the 13 cities across the country where this year's games will be played. and Selection Sunday is celebrated on college and university campuses from coast to coast, where players and their fans have been gathering eagerly awaiting word about where their school will be playing and, in some cases, if they'll be playing in the 2005 NCAA tournament. Coming up, we'll reveal the Chicago bracket when the NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show continues on CBS.
CBS Sports NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show.
Welcome back to our New York studios. Time to reveal the seedings and the pairings. Here's a look at the tournament brackets from the NCAA and its corporate champion, Pontiac, as we look at the Chicago bracket. These are games that are taking place on Thursday and Saturday in Indianapolis, Indiana. And right up there at the top, number one ranked Illinois, the Fighting Illini, will be playing close to home. Winners of the Big Ten title earlier today, and they'll be taking on the 16th seed, Fairleigh Dickinson Knights, out of the Northeast Conference, winners of five of their last six to get into the NCAA tournament. They won the Northeast Conference Tournament Championship. Also in Indianapolis, number eight Texas, the Longhorns, a first round loss in the Big 12 tournament to Colorado, but a school record sixth straight 20-win season. They'll meet ninth seeded Nevada, the Wolfpack, out of the WAC. They won the regular season WAC title. They won their last 10 regular season games and lost in the quarterfinal of the WAC tournament. Thursday, Saturday games to take place in Cleveland. Number five seed Alabama, the Crimson Tide out of the SEC, won seven of their last 10 games heading into the tournament. They'll meet the 12th seeded Panthers of Wisconsin, Milwaukee. They won the regular season Horizon title. They won the Horizon Conference tournament, and they're on their way to the NCAA tournament with an automatic bid. Boston College is the number four seed. Coach Al Skinner's squad started the season 20-0, finished at 4-4 for a 24-4 record. They will meet the 13th seed Quakers of Penn. As we take a look at BC, BC with 24-4 overall, and they'll meet the Quakers from Pennsylvania. They finished the season winning 16 of the last 17 games as they claimed the Ivy League title. On Friday and Sunday in Oklahoma City, these are the games. The second seed, the Cowboys of Oklahoma State, winning the Big 12 championship today, defeating Texas Tech. They've won four of their last five entering the tournament, and as they sit there and see where they're headed, they're the number two seed. And who they'll face? The 15th seed Lions of Southeastern Louisiana. They entered a tournament winning 13 of their last 15 games. This is their first ever NCAA tournament. The number seven seed, the Salukis of Southern Illinois University out of the Missouri Valley Conference. They've won nine of their last 10. And they're a happy bunch of Salukis. Who are they going to face? The Gales of St. Mary's out of the West Coast Conference, who lost the WCC final to Gonzaga. They're the number 10 seed. Thursday, Saturday games in Boise, Idaho look like this. Number three, Arizona, the Wildcats, with Lute Olson leading the way, lost the Pac-10 tournament final to Washington. They'll meet number 14 seed Aggies of Utah State. And Utah State guys, yeah, you're going up against Arizona. There's the reaction for you. The number 16 seed out of the SEC, LSU. They enter the tournament winners of seven of their last eight games and a heartbreaking loss to Kentucky in the semifinal. They'll take on number 11, UAB. The Blazers, coached by Mike Anderson, have won five of their last six. And the celebration is on from the UAB Blazers out of Conference USA. So that's the first bracket. Take a look close. Welcome back to the NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show. Here's a look at the tournament brackets from the NCAA and its corporate champion, Singular. This will be the Albuquerque bracket. So out of the Albuquerque bracket, here we go. These are Thursday, Saturday games out of Boise, Idaho. That's where the top seed Washington Huskies will do battle. Led by Pac-10 Coach of the Year, Lorenzo Romar, the Huskies are in celebration mode. 27-5 overall, and they're headed for the tournament. They'll meet the Montana Grizzlies out of the Big Sky. They come into the tournament with a six-game winning streak. They won the Big Sky tournament, beating Weber State. The number eight seed, the Tigers out of Pacific, The Big West regular season champions, a 22-game winning streak came to an end in the Big West final, but they're one of the hotter teams in the nation. They'll take on the ninth seed Pitt Panthers from the Big East. They've lost four of their last six games. They come in with a 20-8 record out of the Big East. Now, Friday, Sunday games to be played in Nashville. The number five seed, the Yellow Jackets of Georgia Tech, losers of the ACC tournament final today by one to Duke. They've won six of their last 10 games. They'll meet the 12th seed Colonials of George Washington. George Washington making their first tournament appearance since 1999. And I think they're pleased with it. 22-7 overall. They've won 10 of their last 12. The number four seed, Louisville Cardinals from Conference USA. They have won 18 of their last 19 games and 9 in a row. Conference USA tournament champions. They will meet the Raging Cajuns of Louisiana Lafayette. The Sun Belt Tournament Championship under their belt. And Thursday, Saturday games out of Cleveland, Ohio now. The number two seed, Wake Forest. The Demon Deacons had hopes of being a number one seed. Their winners of 10 of their last 12. Skip Prosser's team will meet the 15th seeded Mox of Chattanooga. The Mox returned to the tournament for the first time since 97. They were winners of the Southern Conference Tournament. Number seven seed, Mountaineers of West Virginia, sprung all kinds of upsets in the Big East tournament. And the celebration is on for the Mountaineers out of the Big East. They lost the Big East final to Syracuse. Who will they meet? Out of the Missouri Valley Conference, the Blue Jays of Creighton. Coach Dana Altman has taken the Jays to the tournament six of the last seven seasons. They're on an eight-game winning streak, including their Missouri Valley tournament title. Thursday, Saturday games in Tucson, Arizona now. The number three seed, the Bulldogs of Gonzaga. They're on a 12-game winning streak. They won the regular season West Coast Conference title as well as the conference tournament. They meet the Winthrop Eagles out of the Big South, and the Eagles to the tournament five times in the last 7 years. They own the nation's longest winning streak at 18 in a row. They come in with a record of 27-5. The number six seed, the Red Raiders of Texas Tech, who showed so much in the Big 12, coming up losers in the Big 12 championship game to Oklahoma State. They'll face the Bruins of UCLA, the number 11 seed. 11 national championships to UCLA's history. It'll be UCLA against Texas Tech. Clark, Seth, go.
Well, you take a look at the top part of this bracket, and I tell you what, Pittsburgh is an interesting team. Look ahead to perhaps them matching up with Washington if the seeds hold out. As diagram there, Pittsburgh strong up front, able to be dominant inside. That's where Washington may find some struggle.
They got to get by Pacific, by the way, which I don't think they're going to do. Very surprised to see Louisville out of four. I don't think Rick Pitino and company are going to be happy with that. But my goodness, these teams can put points on the board. Also, look at George Washington as a 12. That tells me if they lost in the Atlantic 10, they would not have gotten an at-large bid. And again, I see lots of points on the board. I hope the scoreboard operator in Albuquerque gets a good night's sleep, because whoever gets to Albuquerque is going to put a lot of points
bottom
on.
Half of the bracket.
Well, you look ahead now. If it holds up according to the seeds, number two Wake Forest against Gonzaga in a potential regional semifinal. Two teams that have great balance inside and out.
I agree. Wake Forest is going to be very tough there, but watch out for Georgia Tech. They've been very hot lately, and they're coming into this tournament hot.
All right, guys, let's take it out to Jim and Billy in Chicago.
Siding and doors, call Suburban Construction today.
We welcome you back live, and we continue live on the NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show right now. A look at the tournament bracket from the NCAA and its corporate champion Coca-Cola as we run down the Syracuse bracket. These are games played on Friday, Sunday in Charlotte, North Carolina, and the top seed, the Tar Heels of North Carolina, the ACC regular season champs. They led the nation in scoring. They've won eight of their last nine games. They will play the winner of the opening round game on Tuesday in Dayton, Ohio, between Oakland University, the Golden Grizzlies out of the Mid-Continent, and they'll take on the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M, making their first NCAA tournament appearance, winners of the Southwestern Conference regular season and tournament. So it'll be Oakland, Alabama A&M winner against North Carolina. Number eight seed, the Golden Gophers of Minnesota out of the Big Ten. And that's Golden Gopher country. And their reaction? They finished the year winning five of their last six games. They'll meet the Cyclones of Iowa State out of the Big 12. Cyclones back to the tournament for the first time since the 0-1 season. And an 18-11 record overall. Now, for Friday, Sunday games to be played in Nashville, the number five seed Villanova Wildcats out of the Big East. They lost the Big East semifinal to West Virginia. But do they care? Now, they finished the regular season on a seven-game winning streak. Coach Jay Wright's team will meet the number 12 seed, the Lobos of New Mexico, who won the Mountain West tournament, defeating Utah. They come into the tournament winners of 9 in a row. The number 4 seed from the SEC, the Florida Gators, so impressive in the postseason. Billy Donovan's Gators, 20 game winners for the 7th straight season. They'll meet number 13, Ohio. The Bobcats making their first tournament appearance since 1994. They've won 8 of their last 9. They won the conference tournament in overtime at the last second. On Friday, Sunday games in Worcester, Massachusetts, the number 2 seed, the Huskies of the University of Connecticut, the defending national champions. They'll meet number 15 seed, Central Florida, the Golden Knights out of the Atlantic Sun. They've won 12 of their last 13 games and are tournament ready. That large bid at number 7 goes to the 49ers of Charlotte, Bobby Lutz's 5th tournament appearance at Charlotte. They'll face the 10th seed Wolfpack of North Carolina State out of the ACC. They won 4 of their last 6 to enter the tournament. Friday, Sunday games in Oklahoma City. The Kansas Jayhawks, the number 3 seed. They lost the Big 12 tournament semifinals to Oklahoma State. In fact, they've lost 5 of their last 8 games. Bill Self's team is going to play number 14, Bucknell Bison. Our boss, Les Moonves, a happy Bison graduate. They won the Patriot League tournament. The number 6 seed, the Badgers of Wisconsin. Wisconsin losing in the championship game today in Chicago to the Fighting Illini, but the Badgers come in at 22-8 overall. They'll face the number 11 Panthers of Northern Iowa. Panthers finished the season winning 7 of their last 10 games, lost to Southwest Missouri State in the quarterfinals of the Missouri Valley Conference. What do you think, guys?
Well, Rob and Amber.
I'm done.
New Amazing Race, CBS Tuesday.
We welcome you back to our studios here in New York. Here is a look at the tournament brackets from the NCAA and its corporate champions as we reveal the 4th and final bracket, the Austin Regional. These games to be played Friday and Sunday in Charlotte, North Carolina. The top seed, the Duke Blue Devils, winners of the ACC Tournament Championship over Georgia Tech earlier today, winners of 7 of their last 8 games, 7 straight Sweet 16 appearances. They'll meet the 16th seed, Delaware State Hornets, making their first NCAA tournament appearance. They come in with an 8-game winning streak. They won the conference tournament final, beating Hampton by 2 points. The number 8 seed, the Stanford Cardinal, lost the Pac-10 semis to Washington. They've split their last 6 games. They'll meet the Mississippi State Bulldogs, the number 9 seed, making their 4th straight tournament appearance. Friday, Sunday games in Worcester, Massachusetts. The 5th seed, the Spartans of Michigan State University. They won 12 out of the last 14 to finish 2nd in the Big Ten. They'll meet the number 12 seed, Old Dominion Monarchs. The Monarchs with a school record 28 wins this season. The number 4 seed, Syracuse, the Orange, getting stronger as the Big East tournament went along and claimed the championship for the first time since 1992. They'll take on the Catamounts of Vermont, the number 13 seed out of the America East. What do you think, guys?
Well, you look at this. Those guys. Oh, I thought you were asking me. I was ready to react.
Thursday, Saturday games in Indianapolis. We just ignore Clark like we do around here. The number 2 seed, Kentucky Wildcats. The Wildcats make it 14 straight tournament appearances. They lost the SEC final to Florida today, but they've won 6 of their last 8. Who do they meet? The Colonels of Eastern Kentucky out of the Ohio Valley with a school record 22 wins. I think they saw that game earlier today. They want a little piece of the Kentucky Wildcats, too. The number 7 seeds out of Conference USA, the Cincinnati Bearcats. They've won 6 of their last 7. Their only Conference USA loss quarterfinal to South Florida. And they'll meet the 10th seed, Iowa Hawkeyes, coached by Steve Alford. He takes Iowa to the tournament for the first time since the 01 season. Thursday, Saturday games in Tucson, Arizona. The 3rd seed, the Oklahoma Sooners, coached by Kelvin Sampson, won their last 6 regular season games to share the league title with Kansas. They'll take on the Purple Eagles of Niagara, the number 14 seed, coached by Joe Mihalik. And the celebration is on. Niagara, their first tournament since 1970. 35 years, it's been a long time. Welcome back, Purple Eagles. And the number 6 seed, the Utes of the University of Utah out of Mountain West. And who will they play? They lost their Mountain West final to New Mexico. They'll take on the 11th seeded Miners of UTEP out of the WAC. Won the WAC tournament title over Boise State, and the celebration is on there as well. And that fills out the NCAA tournament for this year.
Yeah, so now I get to react, right? I get to react. Well, this is their loss to UAB. Actually got beat head-to-head twice to UAB, and I think that probably booted them out and put Northern Iowa in. So I can't argue too much with this particular bracket at all. I mean, the top four seeds are teams we talked about quite a bit over the last couple weeks, particularly Washington late.
Yeah, I think you can quibble with Florida and Louisville over a two. I'm looking at Gonzaga. I'm looking at Kansas. But you can't really argue with what they've done here. And I think it's great that Washington did get to the one line. They really kind of slid in there at the end. They played some great basketball.
Yeah, as we look now at the conference breakdown, you see that six out of the Big East, six more out of the Big 12 conference, five out of the Big 10, which may surprise some people, five out of the ACC.
Well, Iowa came on strong late and certainly did a nice job to work themselves back into the tournament picture. But you take a look at the non-power conferences, and that's been a trend. About 9 to 10 teams from those non-power conferences on average the last 4 years, and we're right about at that number again this year.
Yeah, the Missouri Valley Conference, I think, had a great year, and they obviously got rewarded with their three teams. And, I think this is a good trend, but again, I just think it's become more and more difficult to be able to compare these power conference teams with the teams from the non-power conferences. It's really hard.
Now, the last teams in to the field of 65, you agree or disagree?
Well, I agree. I mean, other than the fact that DePaul didn't make it again, I thought the head-to-head battle with UAB was where that was going to hurt DePaul, and I think it did in terms of Northern Iowa being there. But everybody else, I'm in agreement with. I had those teams in.
As usual, Clark's a lot more agreeable than I am. And I usually don't give the benefit to the Power Conference teams, but I just think Notre Dame had a lot of quality wins, the hardest Big East schedule. And I put Indiana there because I really have a problem with Iowa getting in over Indiana. Indiana finished three games ahead of Iowa in the Big Ten regular season. The committee's basically saying the conference regular season doesn't matter.
We've had this conversation in terms of the